Good afternoon and welcome to Truro Cathedral. I'm Alden Wright, the organ scholar here, and it's my pleasure to introduce today's recitalist, who has come to us from not very far away and has organized quite an interesting and varied program, which I hope that you'll enjoy. So thank you for being here today. It's great to see you all. And please note that next week's recitalist will be Sebastian Heindl, all the way from Leipzig, Germany. So I hope to see you here again next week as well. Without further ado, please welcome Michael Hoeg.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much indeed for coming to hear the organ this afternoon. I'm going to say a few little bits and pieces about the music, which I hope you won't have on your sheet already, but if there is a clash, I apologise. You can see there's a lot about Myron Roberts, not much about Perotin. Perotin was a composer working in Paris, and we think probably round about Notre Dame, in the 12th to the 13th century. In those days, they used a lot of organum, which was parallel fourths and fifths, and you'll hear a lot of this in the piece that I'm going to play you. He's also noted for his discords. So there are some discords, but bear in mind the piece was written in 1943, so they're not that bad. It was composed in 1956. Vierne's Berceuse. A Berceuse is a lullaby, basically. As you can see from your notes, his baby was very young. I think it was about two when he wrote this. You can imagine a nice sunny afternoon in a Parisian flat with this baby laying there making gurgling noises. Could you notice the rhythm for later? Because when we get to the Cochereau piece at the other end, it is actually in homage to Vierne, and you'll find that he uses the rhythm. It's not a set of variations, it's just a feeling, but it does help to know the first piece, the Vierne Berceuse. Thomas Tomkins was organist at Worcester Cathedral. He had been called up to the Chapel Royal to write some of the coronation music for King Charles I. Sadly, Gibbons, who was supposed to do most of it, actually died, and so Tomkins was left with the whole lot. He had to do the whole of Charles I's coronation music. You can imagine how desolated he was when Oliver Cromwell hove into sight. Oliver Cromwell's Puritans kicked out the choir, they trashed the organ, and of course they executed the king. And a couple of weeks after this, he poured out his heart in this piece. Not much to say about Siegesfier. One of the last pieces that Reger wrote, his seven pieces for organ, of which this was the last one. It's based on "Now Thank We All Our God and Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken." The Buxheimer Orgelbuch, the translation of the three titles, Mary Comfort Me is the first one. The second one is The Sweet Nightingale, which will contain a first for the cathedral, because one of the unsung heroes of the organ is the two-foot stop on the choir. So I shall use the two-foot stop on the choir on its own. You probably won't ever hear it again. There's probably a very good reason for that. Lieber Zit. Well, Lieber means sweet, although I'm afraid I've been unable to discover what Zit means. The Cochereau was a tribute to Louis Vierne, who was his predecessor at Notre Dame. The interesting feature of that is right at the end, we can't work out how Cochereau actually played that. So you'll see a third hand stealing onto the screen, which isn't mine, obviously, it's Alden's. So thank you, Alden, for putting that bit in. And Montague, Phillips, Empire March, not much to say about that. It's if you know the Elgar Pomp and Circumstance marches, it's very similar to those. Once again, thank you very much indeed for coming.